good channel. Episode 3 of RB3 Production Podcast Edition. I have DBR, former Southwestern College defensive back. Introduce yourself for the pod.
Nice to meet y'all, channel. My name is Travon Crockett, former DBASC. Good to be here.
Okay, Travon, where are you from? Where's the home roots?
Okay, the home roots are Dallas, Texas, man. The home roots are Dallas, Texas.
How was it growing up in, you know, I would have to say everything bigger in Texas. How was it growing up there?
Man, I'm not going to lie. It was a struggle. Mm-hmm. Especially growing up from Dallas, it was definitely a struggle dealing with a lot of things in the neighborhoods and then just trying to stay focused in school and in sports. So it was definitely a struggle.
Okay. And then, you know, how like in Texas, so did you play multiple sports growing up, or are you mainly just football?
Mainly just football. I wish I would have played multiple sports, though. I wish I would have played other sports. I wish I would have played baseball, honestly.
Really?
Yeah.
So if you had to go back and you had to kind of redo it, you would probably try sign yourself, or you would convince your parents or family to sign you up for the baseball, kind of like the multi-sports, in a sense?
With that, I have to start early with baseball, see. If you start baseball too late, then you might as well not even try.
Okay. So, like, at what age did you start playing football?
Honestly, I can say three years old. Oh. I remember playing flag football at four, so definitely 3 years old. Just in the neighborhood with my older cousins, as they go outside to play football, I just go right behind them.
Mm-hmm. And it's one of those things we're growing up too. You play with the big boys.
No mercy rules. No mercy.
You can't be crying too. No, don't go back home crying. Yeah. No. You cry, you never gonna. You never gonna play again.
You ain't coming back. You cry, you're not coming back.
For sure. So like, you know, did you so in Dallas, did you always play in like the same hometown? Like for me, for example, I was always like. Mentioned other pods, like everybody knows. Like I always played like Kapaw, so like I was Kapaw Eagles, Kapaw Junior Warriors. I went high school, like every like school I was in was just Kapaw. Like that was my town. Did you go to like different towns growing up for school and like sports?
For school, yeah, definitely. For sports, I didn't start school sports until 8th grade. So, but Pee Wee and Little League like that, I played for 2 different towns. I played for the Mesquite Steelers, that's a town that's originally where my high school is originated at. And then I played for the Oak Cliff Ravens, that's in Dallas. So
And like, you know, I know there's like many different leagues. So did you play like Pop Warner, like Big Bird? I know there's like, you know how like the Friday Night Tights said Typha? Did you play ever in Typha?
Never in Typha.
Oh, but then so like what leagues are there? Because besides like Pop Warner and like the Typha?
I'm not gonna lie, I didn't really get into much of the leagues with the little league football sports, but I don't know. That's a good question. I gotta look more into that.
Yeah, we can definitely look into that. So, like, leading up your youth ball, and then so where did you play your intermediate ball?
Played my first football at McDonald Middle School.
Oh damn!
Yeah.
You guys got sponsored by any chance?
Nah, it's sponsored by McDonald's. I wish. It was actually an all-purpose school, just like SC. Oh. We ended up going undefeated my first season, my first and last season.
Oh, damn. Okay, so leading up your youth ball, so it seems like you had a pretty good youth career leading up to everything. So coming into high school, so for your town, did you have any options to choose where you could have gone to high school, or was it because I know it's so big, the town?
Yeah,
you know what I mean, like Dallas. Yeah.
With my town, Mesquite, it consists of 5 high schools, about a couple of middle schools and a couple of elementary schools. So out of those 5 high schools, I had 2 high schools to choose out of, which was North Mesquite and West Mesquite. So I went with North Mesquite. I didn't really have a say so in it because the head football coach, we used to have little meetups after season and stuff with the North Mesquite head football coach and then the West Mesquite head football coach.
Okay.
And like, you know, when we did those meetups, the North Mesquite football coach, he came and pulled me as I was going towards the West Mesquite meetup. You're going this way. And you're coming here. So.
He stagged you, he's like, nope, you're coming here. Yeah. Okay, and like, if you have to say in your high school, how was your high school career? Like, what would you say your, like, how was it for you in your high school, like, career?
My high school career was good. I think I ended the season. I ended my high school career with 7 interceptions, mm-hmm. over 300 tackles, over 20 PBUs, and about 5 forced fumbles.
Oh, shit. And then, so, like, were you on varsity all 4 or all 3?
After my freshman year, I got on varsity.
Oh, so, okay. Yeah. I see. So, like, with Texas, too, you must have played with some crazy competition. Is there any, like... Is there a lot of people you played against, like, in high school that, like, are in the league or draft bound right now, or any, like, top guys that you can think of?
Yeah, I can say my junior year, we went deep into the playoffs that year. We went three rounds deep, and we ended up playing Sam Ellinger.
Oh.
Yeah.
Whoa, how was that?
That game right there, man. Bring back some nightmares. that was a nightmare game. It was cold, it was raining, and we were outside, so it was like, man, it was tough. I mean, mm-hmm. we tried to put up a good fight, but shoot, when you're going up against the Gatorade National Player of the Year, then
He was putting on a show.
Hey, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then, so, like, also you being from Texas, playing in that great college, like, or not college, but high school stadium atmosphere, like, how big was, like, the stadium must, and your facilities must have been, like, compared to even, like, the colleges, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It must have been crazy, yeah?
You can definitely look up, like, the biggest high school football stadiums in Dallas and in Texas, and my high school stadium, my high school football stadium will come up in the top 5.
Really?
Yeah.
So how was that, like, Friday Night Lights atmosphere?
It was amazing. It's like a tower that's in the back of the end zone, and it's like a huge tower. You just look up, it just looks like it's just leaning, it's gonna fall down on you. So, like, stadium is huge, lights, bright, just, then the fans yelling. So, yeah, it was crazy. The atmosphere was crazy, like, energy was there, definitely. Texas energy was good.
Especially, did you, you know, I call it, like, did you ever play at the Star Dallas Cowboys Stadium?
Oh, yeah, most definitely. Once mm-hmm. you make the playoffs and everything, that's the first place you go play at. It is in the Star.
Oh, so they hold, like, most of their playoff
games.
Well,
actually, not the first place. It's the second place you go play at.
Oh, okay, so if you get past that first round, mm-hmm. then you're right in the Star. Yep. So you have to, how much time did you play in that stadium?
Unfortunately, once. It could have been twice. We could have played Sam Ellinger there, but didn't happen. But unfortunately, once we played Colleen Shoemaker, and that was the same year we played Sam Ellinger. That was the second round.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah, came out to a dog fight too. Mm-hmm. Ended up winning 14-13.
Oh, so you got a dub in there.
Yeah.
So how was that experience? You know, you're a Dallas Cowboys fan, so how did that feel playing? Like, you're playing at, like, the Dallas Cowboys Stadium.
That felt amazing. Just even being in the locker room, and then just from walking through the tunnels, like, it's just like, dang, I'm really here. Like, I'm really finna get ready and play at the AT&T Stadium. Like,
yeah.
Is this really happening? Like,
that shit, that's crazy. So, you know, we're talking about your high school. So, step into the next chapter. How was your recruitment, you know, from, like, how was your recruitment coming out of high school?
I say my recruitment was good. I mean, I got looked at by a couple of D1 schools, didn't really meet their standard just because of my height. So, mm-hmm. they really just set me back a little. So, I mean, I got looked at by SMU, Colorado, North Texas. I looked at by a couple of D1 schools.
Okay, I see. So, and then with that all stuff happening, when did you, like, do you feel like your recruitment really started taking off? Were you early, or was it happening more later into your senior year?
With me, it happened more later into my senior year.
Yeah. And then, so how did you end up at Southwestern?
Southwestern ended up being the only school that offered me. So,
oh, I see.
Yeah. So it was one of those, I mean, it's either you take this chance now or that much, the chance is never going to come back around.
It's kind of like one of those things where it's like you have the opportunity set in front of you. You don't know how long it's going to be there, so you might as well take it. You know what I mean? Just I feel like the opportunity just to play college football at the next level. Like, I talked in other videos, I feel like NAIA is really underrated for the rate of football.
Yeah,
like,
definitely underrated.
I compare it, like how I said, like it's like a JUCO 2.0. You have a lot of guys who, you know, overlooked. And also, too, like, guys, eligibility problems, you know. And then you just come with, like, all those guys who are just dogs that come out here. So I feel like that's pretty cool. But so leading into coming to Southwestern, how was it when you first got here as a freshman? Like, how did it start for you?
Started off tough. I didn't know what to expect. I mean, we came in, say, after builder camp, we came in getting ready for two-a-days. This is back when we still could run 2-a-days. So we came in doing that, even starting off with the cardio test. We had the cardio test at the beginning of every fall.
This was old SC,
old SC. We used to have our special teams meeting at 5 in the morning. If you were late, breakfast club, you had to be there, no excuses. Like, it was a lot. We used to, especially during the fall camp, we had no days off. Honestly, we was in meetings and practice from 6 a.m. to 7 p.m., sometimes 9 p.m., so, yeah.
Okay, I see. And, like, was your baseball camp, was it, like, 1 week, like, 2-a-day, or was it a 2-week, 2-a-day?
It was a 1 week, 2-a-day.
Oh, okay, I see. Okay, and then leading your freshman year, so when did you claim that starting job, you know?
I honestly think I claimed it at the end of fall camp, going into the preparation of the first week of my freshman year, that first week of game. I honestly think that's when I claimed it. So.
Okay, I see. And then, like, obviously you had some good accolades and stuff like that. So, like, what were, like, some of your accolades while being, you know, you started as a freshman, you know, and then was it your late, that freshman year where you all conference, or was it after fresh, it's like sophomore, junior, and then your
sophomore, junior, and then senior year,
Okay, that was pretty cool. So how was it though, like, seeing Southwestern, like, when you first came here, you guys had, like, what was it, a 5-5 record? And then you guys went to 7, like, it was started to improve. And then, like, that last kind of, like, your the COVID year, for example, that's when you guys almost, that's when you guys came 9-2, and then the year after. So
I honestly say the just seeing Southwestern improve so much has just been honestly a work of not only the coaches, but a work of the players and as a whole, just wanting to make a change, just wanting to be different and wanting to set a true foundation for yourself once you leave Southwestern. So I say that just the culture of the players, every player that came in from each year until now has made a big factor to that change. And then I want to put a big shout out to the 2017 class, because that was a class that I came in with. And most don't even give us the credit to say, but I feel like we were a huge and major change to this program. So I just want to say,
Because then a lot of those guys, the 2017, that was kind of when everything just, like, just seeing, like, that shift, because like you always said, you guys always had the players, but then it's like, what, bro, once that shift happened, it was good to see you guys just put in that work. And you always tell me those stories and stuff. So, you know, your original graduation year or your original senior year was the COVID year, you know what I mean? So you finished off, you know, you're supposed to be done and everything. So, like, how was it after, so, you know, the COVID season? You left Southwestern to go start working and all that stuff. So, like, tell me a little about, like, that kind of, that journey. And
So, after the COVID season, I actually decided to take a year off. My girlfriend had got an opportunity after she graduated from the University of Louisiana, Monroe. She's now a radiation therapist, so I went up with her to Arkansas while she was in school for that and just started working and just providing there. And then I just had a dream one night that I was back in a uniform. So I just took it upon myself to just say, hey, maybe you should go back after after that dream I had, just maybe you should go back. Maybe that was a sign that, hey, you should. You got something.
Kind of God sending you like a little message, you know, that, hey, you're not done yet. You know, you got one more in you. Yeah, I feel you. And then that feeling of coming back, winning and like getting that ring. How was that feeling? How was that? Because I know you would always talk about that, like, bro, like how hard you know what I mean?
Man, that feeling was amazing. That was the greatest feeling ever. Just, man, finally just getting something done that I started here and that a lot of us couldn't do. And I came back and did it for a lot of people that wasn't able to come back and continue doing it. So, I mean, that felt great. That felt amazing. I mean, I really felt like that's really one of my biggest accomplishments for football. It's just coming back, finishing, and also finishing while I win the conference. So.
Yeah, I think it's crazy too, you know, like how you told me, like, you were recognized, you know, I feel like it is like to shine this on you, like for your, just, you know, it's always good team-wise, but I feel like your individual goes like, shit, you're like one of the best DBs in the conference for like 3-4 years, you know what I mean? Like, you had like, you know, you're made all conference your sophomore year, your junior and senior year, your second team, you know what I mean? Like, you, that's like, that's pretty good, especially in the conference, right, with some dogs, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then even this year, like, you came back, you know what I mean? And you still, you know what I mean? You got all conference again, you know what I mean? So I feel like that was pretty sick, too, and just, like, you know, got to, like, me sit behind you and kind of learn, you know, be your roommate. I feel like that was really cool because I got to learn, like, shit, I learned a lot, you know what I mean? Just from, like, being your roommate, playing behind you, and, like, seeing that stuff, bro. It's, like, it's crazy. So you have to say it also, like, overall, what is your biggest accomplishment in football individually, and then also your biggest accomplishment as a team?
Individually, I say my biggest accomplishment in football is just the way I kept controlling my emotions throughout the years of playing football here. So I just say that's one of my biggest accomplishments individually. And then as a team, as a whole, I say winning that conference ring is another one of my biggest accomplishments. So,
especially too, you know what I mean? Like, I feel like that's a big one too. You know what I mean? Saying you get a ring, like, especially from like where your standpoint, bro, you came, you like, you didn't come in like how like I came in, you know what I mean? I came in as a transfer and like kind of came into a winning program. You like were with it from the start, you know. So I feel like that's a really good thing. And kind of like to switch another gear, so like with your numbers, kind of put it on another one, you had quite a few numbers through your career, so tell us about it.
Okay, so my freshman year I started off with number 26. Okay. Of course, as a freshman, you can't pick your numbers.
So yeah.
They give you a number. So I started off with 26. After that, I decided to go back to my high school number, which was 20.
Mm-hmm.
It just reminded me of back of my old self. So I just decided to go back to that number.
Mm-hmm.
And then going into the COVID year, I decided I wanted to change. I decided that I wanted to be different since this was supposedly going to be my last year playing football. So I went with 2, just erased the 0, just made it 2, just, I don't know. And then for this last year, I went with 11.
So what made you like, so, you know, you say like sticks, like what is the meaning behind like that 11?
I mean, one of one. I mean, there's only one of me. I feel you.
That's a good one too, and like, so that's a good kind of like how you have a meaning behind everything, you know what I mean? And then also, so like, what's your plans for after graduation?
Okay, so I'm currently in the Enactus program at Southwestern, so we actually have a conference in Dallas in April in a couple of weeks. So my plans are to like find a good opportunity there and just start my career there. I mean, alternative, I just want to be a entrepreneur. I want to be able to do what I want to do, wake up when I want to and go to sleep when I want to. So I mean my goal in life is to be an entrepreneur, but after school I just start slow.
So. It's kind of like slowly just get into things and like let's God's plan. God's plan. That's good though. And so is there anything that you would like, you know, to give advice to any younger athletes out there, like any recommendations, things you wish you would have done, or anything to help them out?
Stay focused early. Don't let anyone tell you your size matters. Don't let the outsiders get in your ear. I mean, we all know as athletes, we have a lot of people that will try to doubt us and bring us down from what we're doing just because they don't see it in us at the moment, but we see it in ourselves. So I just want to say to all the athletes out there, just whatever you see in yourself, go after your dream, go after your goal. Don't let nobody stop you from doing anything and keep pushing, and it's going to work out one day, one way or another. It's going to work out. Shit.
Mm-hmm. Nah, that's a good thing too. I really like that one, because I feel like a lot of athletes, you know what I mean, like they get discouraged, you know. Let me say that, D1, like how you said, right, your school's looking at you, you know, sadly it didn't work out, but like look, you had a blessing in Southwestern. You still took the opportunity, right, get your degree, get a discount, play college football at a great level. I feel like a lot of athletes, like they're undersized or something doesn't work out and the D1 doesn't come and they get like all depressed, sad.
Also, another thing, if D1 don't come, please don't be scared to go NAIA. There's some NAIA products that's coming to the NFL and you will see them. So don't be scared to go NAIA. It's some ballers. Another thing, if you're talented, those who are watching will come to you. If you are talented enough, everything will come to you.
I feel like that stuff. It's true, because so many kids, you know, like, bro, if you can ball, you're going to shine. You know what I mean? I feel like that's why they get too caught up in this mindset of like, D1 or bust. Like, eh, we understand, like, you're just pushing yourself, but college football is college football. You're gonna be going, you're playing, you're competing against men, dogs, guys who like are like crazy athletes. Like NAIA, any level you go, the guys are the best in their towns, best in their district, whatever you call it. They all states, all conferences. But bro, when you come to college, it's a reset. You gotta prove yourself again. And yeah, I feel like that's the biggest thing to like, yeah, D1 is good, but if you have the opportunity, take it. You know, not many people, mm-hmm. like I remember the last podcast Aaron was mentioning, it's like, God, it's only a percentage, like it's like 6%, 6% of college, high school athletes play college football.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, it gets smaller and smaller. And I feel like that's a cool thing, but.
Yeah.
Bro, I feel like this one is good, bro. Kind of deeper. I liked your little, you know what I mean, your advice, bro. I feel like that's the biggest thing, is having these kids understand, or like people watching, like, bro, there's so many different people from our team, you know, like that just bring different like people together. You know, mm-hmm. you get to meet different people, like shit. Yeah. Like who would ever known you have a roommate from Hawaii?
No, facts.
Exactly. No, like facts. Just the crazy scenarios of everything, but. Nice, Corey. Nice. I'll cut that. I gotta cut that out. What the fuck? Cut this shit out.
Actually,
bro.
I think that'd be funny to keep in there.
Be like, God damn, man.
It just put something in the middle, be like, roommate next door. Bruh,
bro, God. Yeah. No, and the other one too, bro. You hear him like, he's on his game. He's like swearing, bro. The first one, me and Boogie, if you actually listen to the background, I was like, damn, bro. But yeah, I think that's a good one. You know what I mean? I really like that, bro. I think we got some good pod in. You know what I mean?
Heck sure.
Yeah. So I'm gonna try. You know, I'm back at doing this. We took a break for spring break and everything. But if you guys haven't, check out episodes 1 and 2. It's on the channel. But thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and tune in for more.
Hey.
Yeah. Yes, sir.